Greetings, everyone with nasal and sinus complaints. I'm John Craig, Division Chief of Rhinology here at Henry Ford Otolaryngology, or ENT Surgery. I wanted to put a video together to help patients understand the process of seeing a rhinologist. Specifically, when you have nasal and sinus complaints, which may be sinusitis, but may also be a slew of other conditions, migraine, allergic rhinitis, acid reflux, a number of things can actually add up to all the symptoms of sinusitis, and I wanted to take you through how we take the history, as well as some other components to help get you the right diagnosis. To diagnose sinusitis, we have what we call symptomatic criteria and objective criteria. So critical to understand this. You can't have one without the other. What are symptomatic criteria? These are the symptoms you experience on a daily basis or perhaps intermittently. There are six symptoms I'm trying to elicit from your story. One, drainage out the front of your nose. Two, drainage down the back of your throat. Three, nasal obstruction, decreased airflow through the nose, one or both sides. Facial pressure in the cheeks or the forehead. Smell loss or a foul smell in your nose. Okay, so there's actually six. Imagine how those can coexist, happen at different times, sometimes all together. That results in a significant number of variations of symptoms, basically. So I'm trying to tease that out from your story, but on your side of it, you're just experiencing all of them. But if they don't happen together, you can actually have different diagnoses causing all of these different symptoms. Migraine, allergic rhinitis, acid reflux. You add those three conditions together, they can cause all the symptoms of sinusitis. So my job is to tease all that out in 15 to 30 minutes. So that's just the symptom part. So if you ever feel rushed or like I'm interrupting you, I swear, it's not because I'm being rude. It's just that I have to get to the bottom of your condition so that we can optimize your treatment outcomes. So now that we've gone through the history-taking portion of the visit, figured out which symptoms you have, now we're gonna perform the nasal endoscope portion to confirm or refute that diagnosis. To do that, we're gonna bring in a patient who has symptoms that could be consistent with sinusitis, and I'll show you how we perform a nasal endoscope. All right, so we have you sit down in the chair, and now we're gonna perform the nasal endoscope. And so we have typically our ENT toolkit over here in this corner. I have my rigid nasal endoscope here, and this is a pretty standard apparatus. We have the scope hooked up to the scope source, and then the rigid portion or the shaft of the scope with a light at the end. We only place about that much in the nose, and so I have you sit your head back, turn toward me. All right, now before I place the scope in the nose, we're going to spray a topical decongestant and numbing spray, something like this, okay? This has lidocaine and Afrin in it. It's going to decongest tissues to make a more open in the nose so I can see further back, and then the numbing spray obviously makes it more comfortable for you. So I would spray both nostrils, pull the mask down here. All right, have you breathe through your mouth in and out. Helps not fog up the scope. And then I would rest my hand on her forehead and come in each nostril, gently lifting up. Really shouldn't hurt. If it's hurting, we're doing something wrong. Do that on both sides. And now you're going to see on the next part of the video what that actually looks like on the scope and what I'm looking for to diagnose or refute whether you have sinusitis. Now I'm going to show you a few different nasal endoscopies. First, we have a normal nasal endoscopy in somebody who does not have sinusitis, so let's go through a diagram here. First off, this is where you get the biggest bang for your buck during a nasal endoscopy. You're looking at what's called the middle meatus. It's the space lateral to, or on this picture, left of that structure called the middle turbinate, shown now here in the diagram as MT. And below that, you have the inferior turbinate, or IT, and between these two structures, you basically have the middle meatus, shown in yellow there. This is where you're going to find the majority of disease like infection and inflammation emanating from the sinus cavities. And in this first case example, there was no infection or inflammation in that space. Now there are other spaces deeper inside the nose that we look for other types of sinus disease, but this is just to give you an idea of where the majority of sinus infection and inflammation occur. Next is an example of a right-sided nasal endoscopy in a patient with chronic rhinosinusitis and nasal polyps. The yellow arrow shows polyps emanating from the middle meatus lateral to that middle turbinate. Here's an example of a left-sided nasal endoscopy showing frank pus draining from the middle meatus.
The yellow arrow shows the pus lateral to that middle turbinate, but the pus is draining posteriorly into the back end of the nasal cavity and into the throat, which you can see there. And so in summary, for your clinic visit, first we will take a thorough clinical history to figure out which symptoms you have, and then correlate those symptoms with your nasal endoscopy, specifically looking for infection or inflammation in the sinus drainage pathways, with the most commonly involved drainage pathway being the middle meatus, as shown in this diagram.
Okay, so that's what happens at a rhinology visit. I hope everyone learned something, and I look forward to seeing you here at Henry Ford in our rhinology division.